introduce myself. I'm Professor Phasmid, and this is a friend of mine, Fred. And we've both been studying the actual Phasmid society and the stick insects varieties, which there are of many. We're just trying to see what their relationship is with the game Aussie Rules, which is Australian football. We've managed to collect some eggs, put them down. We've had them for a period of 8 months, and they've been able to survive in the most unusual seasons. Actually, these particular variety have come from the northern parts of Queensland, which have got a touch of Brisbane Lion colour about them. One of the things that we have noticed when we brought them down and we've really analysed them closely is that when they're actually hatched out in Victorian areas, they take on a Collingwood look about them, where the gingery browns and associated with them normally in their northern parts are more black and white. We found that the stripe on the Phasmid down in the southern regions is like where we'd normally get like a vertical black and white, sort of like in the Collingwood areas. We're getting a horizontal sort of colour going through, like in Geelong, and like your Richmond and Essendon areas, they're actually going diagonally. So there is some sort of connection with the actual areas that these particular Phasmids are breeding in. What we're trying to actually do is have a better grand final. Like, we've actually worked out that because they're a stick insect, we're trying to align them with the goalposts so that somewhere we can actually have a structure that is not necessarily perfectly perpendicular or vertical, as one might say, but they'll actually be sort of like, I don't know, offset in a way, much like the front feelers on a Phasmid. One of the reasons why this will probably improve the game a lot, as we've seen in a lot of recent games in 2009, is that games have actually been won over very small short kicks where they've just hit the post, where otherwise it could have been a 6-point win to the other side. So Fred has actually put across maybe having a fifth stick. So if there is a fifth stick and we can somehow like make another breakdown of say six, we've got one goal of 6 points, we could have like 1 point down to a breakdown of 1/6 of a Phasmid maybe. We have a small plastic seed which we can be placed under the player's skin. Fred has discovered, try to explain this one, but the actual hair that is produced on a Phasmid, which is not actually visible to everybody to see, but under a microscope becomes quite long in the nether regions, sort of like under the arms and the chin area. On a player, that is quite stunted, and it actually comes on the back of the legs, around the ankle areas, which we're now looking at a completely different way of maybe clothing the actual player themselves. With these actual inserts that go under the skin, they've actually been able to change the skin to the point where a number will be produced on the surface of the skin. It's actually on the player. It's not in any connection with swimming and the new suits or anything like that. It's actually a part of the structure of the individual that they take on. It's actually, it lasts for a season. You still can go up before the board and be transferred to another club. And so none of that will actually change, because they can remove the seed, put the seed back in and out, and when clubs take on new players, as older players leave, this seed can be transferred. It is a Phasmid seed. It's made up of a few molecules. I think it's 2 DNA away from the skink, which is a small lizard, as you all know. But yeah, it's really going to be an interesting season in the next couple of years. Yeah.
We're in one of the northern national parks.
Here we are here. I've just found a whole collection of Phasmids. These guys have just probably hatched over the last 6 or 8 months. They do take an 8 to 9 month period. I've just had 4 hatch at home myself, but see them moving? They scurry around in amongst the growth here. There's plenty of them here. We could probably get almost a full golf stick out of those once we get them all together and work out what we're actually going to do with the golf sticks and how the actual final shape will be of the stick. I've just known since I've had the implant that, you know, things have changed a little bit, and I get these tendencies to try and climb, you know, like we take on all sorts of things, start to allow us to try and take on Phasmidi. Some of these gum leaves, they're actually quite tasty. I don't know whether you've eaten gum leaf before, but
really quite nutritious. Even the dead ones, they're like dried fish. This is the mating dance of the Phasmid. When Collingwood get back into their rooms after a game, it's not all a bear hug and good old Collingwood forever all the time. We've just come across an actual, this is the female Phasmid. You can see the fork of the way it comes back up again. The whole structure of the base down here is quite different to a male structure. This is, without any other word for it, one of the most perfect Phasmids I've ever seen.
One of the things we've noticed is that Mr. Rudd's been putting computers into every school in Australia, and we'd like to see with every computer a Phasmid or two.
The whole function of society right back to the younger generations through, we can approach the kindergartens through to the primary through to tertiary university sections, where people will no longer be going on buses, they will be crawling in a stick formation to universities and completing their degrees in Phasmidic science, Phasmidic maths, Phasmidic chemistry, right through to the AFL sticks. So it's all about trying to cross the bridge and get to the fifth stick.
The newfound respect since I've been a professor. It's a very easy thing to do, PRF on the front of your name. It works really quite well. Of course I like being a professor. People actually listen to me now. Before I became a professor, I was sort of working for the government, taking a few handouts and things. You know, things have really transpired. I've been picked up by a code that's quite identified now, you know, right through society, and I feel quite distinguished. I've been able to you know, meet with some really interesting people, thanks to Fred.
Thanks for allowing us to take a small amount of time to just bring you up to speed on what's been going on the Phasmidic Society. Thank you.
One of the advantages of a Phasmidic lifestyle would be it's just the ease of like moving from one branch to another. It's just hanging around. It's a very simple life. It's all gum.